Hi guys, Janet from My Crazy Little Life. Welcome back. Today I have a review of some Hogg tumblers for you. I order all my cups for my tumbler making from the Stainless Depot. Hoggoutfitters.com is the website. There you go. I order all my tumblers from there. Irene is the woman who owns the company. She has an amazing selection. And she's constantly coming out with new things. And I got to tell you, sometimes it's hard when I'm buying stuff because I have to keep in mind that these aren't for me. These are for my customers. So I don't really need all the things, even though I want all the things. So I was at a horse show last week. First time I ever brought my printer and my press with me, my cup press. And I made on-demand sublimation cups. I would design it right there with the person, put the picture on the cup, whatever, the logo of the horse show. People were super happy with all the custom cups. So I did really well there. It was all custom cups. I did not sell very many of my pre-made. There is a video I have up of my setup, so you can look at it and you can see how many I had with me. And of the pre-made, I maybe sold four of them. Everything else was custom. And I'm okay with that because it was an experiment. It was something new for me to try, and I will absolutely go back next year. It was a lot of fun and I really enjoyed it. I also did a lot of the citrus strip cups, the cups like this where with the powder coating, you remove the paint with the citrus strip and you just put the, you know, like I was, most of the kids, because with that, it has to be very, very simple. Most of the kids were putting their horse's name or their name, their barn name, whatever. So very simple things. But I had a great time doing that, even though it was very, very long days. I would love to be able to do more shows like that because it was a really fun experience. I met some great people. So that got me thinking is how can I take this and go to craft fairs and be able to make on-demand cups at craft fairs? Because when you go to craft fairs these days, not everybody who has a craft fair puts some thought into it. Realistically, if you're going to have a certain kind of craft like tumbler makers or, you know, jewelry makers or whatever, you should try to have two at the max of any one thing. You should, on the form, it should ask what you sell and it should all be listed, and you really should limit because it's very hard. If there's five tumbler makers at a crafting event, it's very hard to be the one that people buy from, even if you have the same products. Like I've been to a couple where I have the same products as someone else does, and even some of the same designs, because we all buy our designs. Like I make a lot of my own designs, but I do buy a lot of designs from design bundles, and so you'll see they're just, it's the same thing. And I've actually had, I had one craft fair that I was at, and there was a tumbler maker directly across the row from me, so we're facing each other. And she lowered her prices lower than mine, and she sold a bunch, and I didn't sell any. And I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to lower my prices, because the money I charge for my cups is the money I need to make, including my costs, my time, my designing, the cost of the product, the cost of my electricity, all that's factored in. So the price of my cups is a static thing. It is not variable. If you order 100 of the same cup from me, I'm probably going to give you a 20% discount because you're ordering 100 of the exact same thing, and I can just print off 100 things, and that makes it a little easier. If you order 100 different cups, you're not going to get a discount because I have to make 100 individual cups, and I don't have a machine that slams these cups out. I have to do each one. So my prices are what they are. So I started thinking about this after I did the horse show, how I can take this stuff with me on the road to be able to make on-demand cups at craft fairs to set me apart from someone else. But to do that, I need internet and I need power. The internet, easy fix. Buy one of the portable internets, not a problem, easy fix. Then the electricity, I have a jump pack for my car. And when you plug it in, it's a giant battery, and that's how you can jump your car if your battery dies or whatever. I don't need it anymore. I bought a brand new car, but I was thinking about it. If I can use that as my power source, but But anything with heating element does take a lot of power. So I've got to play with that and see if that would work for me. And then I can do on-demand cups at craft fairs, which that would set me apart a little bit. I really love doing the citrus strip, the etched glasses, but zero way to do that at a craft fair. They take too long. The citrus strip has to sit on the cup for, 45 minutes to an hour. Impossible to do that. And there's a lot of scrubbing involved. So impossible to do that at a craft fair. But sublimation, absolutely. I could 100% do that at a craft fair. So I'm trying to figure out a way to set myself apart. And I think if I can master the electrical part of it, then I'll have it down. So with all that being said, let's get into this. Hogg. I only buy Hogg tumblers. Hoggoutfitters.com. Love these. These two here, they're 20 ounce skinny, powder coated. So not sublimation, but the powder coated. They come in mint and black. I'm gonna take both of them out for you. Just gotta not have my stuff blow away. So mint and black, 20 ounce. The mint is showing up very blue. Never mind my broken fingernails. I got two I gotta redo. Monday's nail day. So this is really not showing up as minty as it is. It's a very pretty seafoam green kind of color, mint color. So there's the mint and the black. They have the sliding top. I love these cups. They're very, very popular. I do love, like I said, the citrus strip. I love it. When I did the show last week, I brought all my blanks with me. So it was, I didn't have to worry about, oh, do I have any more of those? Can I make it? If I didn't have it with me, I couldn't make it. When I came home from the show, though, I placed an order the next day after I came home, because I had to replace all my stuff. These sold like crazy. So I'm hoping that it'll be the same coming up. Now, my biggest problem is when I have these things, I have to remember that I don't need another cup. There are some really cool new coffee cups. I tried to be selective and just pick a few. My customers in general are not coffee cup people. I have never had great luck with selling coffee cups, but whatever I ate's not agreeing with me, but, I just don't have a big coffee cup base. But how cute are these? These are sublimation, so I can print on them as I need to. Comes with a spoon. The spoon feels like it's ceramic to me. It might not be, but it feels like it's ceramic. So there's a little spoon. It fits right in the hole on the handle. And there's the cup. Black on the inside. They do have other colors. I bought just the black and the red. I don't know if there's other colors with the spoon. But there were so many different coffee mugs this time, and I was like, oh, those are fantastic. I really want to buy them, but like I said, they don't necessarily sell with my people, so I had to keep that in mind. But I do have four of them here to show you that are super, super cute. So that was the black one with the handle. That's a different one. That's a different one. Hold on. Gotta get this box. I don't really have a lot of different ones to show you this time, but I do have... the ones I have are super fun. Oh, there goes the spoon. Red spoon. This one here, I just dropped it on my dog sleeping next to me. I just dropped it on. He looked at me all indignant and mad. So same thing, red inside, white sublimation, red handle. I mean, these are just adorable to be able to put your spoon right there. I don't know, honestly, I'm not sure if I would enjoy this because, you stir it. This might be fun if you were to make this like a chocolate spoon where you cover it in chocolate, like sprinkles or whatever, put it like this and give it as a gift. I don't know how it would be once you use the spoon and then you put it in, if it's going to drip down your handle or whatnot, but we'll see. So I got just the two of those, the black one and the red one. I think these are super fun. I'll probably do Christmas designs on them. Because coffee cups, if they do sell, tend to be winter themed. They tend to sell much better with a winter theme. Okay, this next one. Now, when I saw this one online, it was just the angle of the picture that gave it the illusion that it did. But, oh, it's just cool looking. This is a ceramic mug. Look at this. It's silver. Got the white inside. This is also a sublimation mug. How cool is that? I am a big, big fan of the clear, what's called the clear cups, which are just the stainless steel cups with the sublimation coating on them. And I like the way it gives almost like a 3D style. So I'm hoping on this it'll do the same. So we'll see what design I come up with for that. And then this one. Oh, this one's just the sweetest. Wonderful Valentine's Day type thing. Maybe put a picture of your sweetheart on it or something. We'll see. We'll see what people come up with. But look at this with the little heart. It's pink on the inside, white. This one is an 11 ounce. Super, super cute. So I'll come up with some designs for those. I just thought those were really fun with the pink heart handle. I don't know if I told you the ounces on the other mugs. 11 ounce on the silver. They're all of them are 11 ounces. So that's the only coffee mugs I bought. I didn't hold on. There's a motorcycle about to roll by. I'm gonna save these. There's five that I just love, love, love. I'm gonna kind of keep those till the end because they're sort of my favorite. So I have two others I'm gonna show you first. And then I'm gonna move this pile so it's not in the way of the camera and it doesn't tip over. All right, this one here. Now I've been selling these. This is a 20 ounce duo. The reason they call it a duo is because it comes with two lids. Now I had a ton of the 15 ounce ones that I bought for kids. They're great for kids because they have the flip up straw lid and this little, let me see if I get it at the right angle, this little clip. So you can clip it like on your belt or your backpack or whatever. And it's a good strong, it's a screw on lid. So it would hold. So these, I had, like I said, I had the 15 ounce, which is a great size for kids. And then it also comes with the regular lid that you can use as well. Why it's called a duo. So I figured since these are so popular with kids, they might also be popular with adults. And actually I did sell quite a few of them at the show last week to adults. So I thought maybe a larger size would be good too. And a lot of people like the water bottle, that was hard to say, style. And with the clip, you know, being able to take it, clip it on your backpack and whatnot, it's just that's a really popular style. So let's see. Now this one, when the people online, this one is a 25 ounce sublimatable holographic tumbler. And so I had several of the posts on the Facebook page had said that the holographic one, I'm not sure if you can't really get the true sheen sense. But it has almost like an oil slick look to it. Regular sliding top, pops off, pops on. People online were saying, oh, the holographic ones, they're so hard to sublimate. Well, I gotta tell you, I didn't find them hard to sublimate at all. And they are adorable when you do them up. Especially if you have a really vivid, design, it looks fantastic. And these are gorgeous. So they just take a little more processing time, but they're pretty fantastic. So happy, happy, happy with those. Can't wait to do those in the bigger size. Okay. Now these two, when I saw these online, I was like, you have got to be kidding me. These are gorgeous. And I had to remind myself I don't need another mug because I don't. But I'm gonna have one. So these two are the 20 ounce holographic skinnies. straight edge. Okay. These are beautiful. Beautiful. So again, the camera's not really doing the holographic much justice, but it's got sort of like an oil slick sheen to it, but it comes in the pink and the mint. And again, the camera's making this look much more blue than it is. It's definitely much more green. So super excited to try those, because like I said, I did the other holographic and I loved it. And the image you put on it makes all the difference. It's absolutely gorgeous. So I'm really, really happy with those two. Can't wait to design something. I only bought a couple of them because I would rather keep my stock low, because their shipping is so fast. Hogg shipping is so fast for me anyway. I've been very, very lucky. And if I order, generally, and this is just me again, there's no guarantee this is going to happen for you. But when I order, if I order by 3 o'clock in the afternoon, actually, there's been times where I order at noon and I have the product at noon the next day. It comes that fast. So it's perfectly okay for me to wait and to have, I'd rather keep low stock and have someone say to me, hey, can you put this on that? Oh, I don't have any of those. I'll order them, because it's not hard to put an order together and have them quick enough. So as long as people are close enough, it's not a big deal. These next three, they come in French vanilla, white, and mint. Now I gotta tell you, when I saw these online, I thought they were plastic. The way they look online, I thought they were plastic. They are not. They're absolutely freaking gorgeous. These are a 24 ounce dual flip slim. Now, if you look at the thing on the back here, let me see, I'm gonna try to figure out where the best way is. It says you can sip through the straw or you can swig through the opening. So this cup, when I saw it online, look at this. It looked plastic to me, and it comes with this super cute little holder, so you can, you have something to hold on to. If you're a busy mom, busy whatever, you got a lot of things in your hands, this strap, and it's on there. It's not, your lid's not coming off. You have to unscrew the lid. So this is a stainless steel double walled. Again, the mint is looking very, very blue on the camera. It's not. It is an absolutely gorgeous shade. The straw comes with it. And then once you screw the lid back on, if you put it on correctly, you screw the lid back on, you've got the gulping side, or the chugging side as they call it. You put that one down and you flip this side up, and it's the straw, much like the Duo that I just showed you. So I am super excited about these. It's got the cute little strap. It's a great size, also powder coated, so I won't be sublimating these. Most likely I'll be etching these. If people ask me, I will put vinyl on them. I don't necessarily love putting vinyl on cups anymore, unless I'm epoxying them, because I've had some customers that the vinyl has stayed on for years. And I have one friend, I give a tumbler care card with every tumbler I sell. And it explicitly says on there, do not put in the dishwasher. It's a couple of reasons you don't put them in the dishwasher. You don't put the vinyl ones in the dishwasher because the heat heats up so high that it can take the vinyl off. And you're also not supposed to put any of your double-walled tumblers in the dishwasher because you risk breaking the seal. So I do have one friend, however, that doesn't care. And everything she has goes into the dishwasher. And so she's had great luck. I don't like selling stuff to people and hoping they have good luck. I like selling stuff to people and giving them all the right information. But I have had people come back, and you know if someone's dropped a cup and broken it. I mean, if you drop an epoxy tumbler onto the asphalt or the cement, it's gonna chip, it's gonna break or crack or whatever. poor handling. I don't even know what is coming down the street. Oh, it's the street sweeper, sorry. I heard something coming down the street and I was like, this is weird. So I give people care instructions and, you know, you want to make your customer happy, but you have to be aware of mistreatment, or if they, you know, you can tell if something's been put, if an epoxy tumbler has been put in the dishwasher, you'll see a smoke ring around it is the best way I can describe it, where it separates from the cup. If it's been dropped and cracked, whatever. Oh, no, I didn't drop anything. If you lose track of something and it slams down even onto your marble countertop, you risk breaking it. But for the most part, these are extremely durable. So these, with the powder coating, I love it. I love, love, love these. I've been doing a lot more of the citrus strip and I really enjoy it. So I can ramble on. That's what that whole last thing was, but that's what I do. Those of you that know me know that I do that. These two cups. So here's the white and the French vanilla. Now, these are just beautiful cups. You know, they've got the little tag, the little handle. They are slightly tapered, but they've got a good, I have tiny hands. No problem for me to hold this at all. This strap part, you're not gonna get your wrist into it. Absolutely not. This is a three, you know, slipping it. You could slip it on something, you're gonna slip it. Again, I have tiny hands. You're gonna be able to hold onto it without an issue. You're definitely gonna hold onto it, but it's not going on your wrist. But that being said, I think these are gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous tumblers. I will most likely, I'm on the fence because this French vanilla is absolutely gorgeous. So I'm on the fence whether I want the French vanilla or whether I will do the mint color. But either way, I see one of these in my future. I always tended to like the big cups, but honestly, lately what I've been doing, I don't like to drink water. I try and I don't like to. So lately what I've been doing is I've been making up some, like this is orange crush, but I also put some vanilla syrup in it. So I'll make this, so it's a flavored water, and then I have my cup, and it is full of ice. And I don't know if you can see how. See, I like ice in my cups. So I'll fill it up, and then I'll just keep refilling it with that. So I don't need, and I do that even when I go into the office. I don't need a big cup. So I'm kind of digging these 20, you know, the 20 to 24 ounce cups. So it works. I don't need a big giant cup because I do have one. It's the 32 ounce. It's big. And it's, I did it with epoxy, way back. I've had this cup 5 years easy and it is broken. I've dropped it. I've cracked the epoxy. I've done it all. The cup still maintains the ice. It still maintains the temperature. It's great. I love it. But it's big. It's 32 ounces. It's big. It's a little hard for me to hold. So if I have it on my desk or whatever and I can just tip it and drink it with the straw, that's great. But I do find these little ones to be slightly better. I'm much happier with them. So there'll probably be a new cup in my future. I don't know. So with all that being said, I love these products. I love the company. The customer service is amazing. While I was at the show, I had two cups that did not sublimate well. And I know that it wasn't something I was doing, because for one lady, I made four candle holders. I made three cups. I made, she had a whole bunch of stuff that I made for her. And I made it all right there in front of her. And one item out of all of them didn't sublimate. It sublimated like a shadow. And generally that's, you don't have the right pressure, you don't have the right heat, whatever. And I could get behind that if I hadn't made a bunch of other cups at the same time, you know, some before that cup and some after, that all came out absolutely perfect. So I went on to the Facebook group. There is a Facebook group specifically for Hogg. I was on there and I just asked, because a lot of times people will ask, you know, did anybody else have problems with this cup? Because if you're doing everything else right and you have one cup that you're having a problem with, maybe there was a bad batch. Maybe there's a tip or a trick or something that someone else can tell you and you're like, oh, duh, what was I thinking? But I made two of these cups at the show. I only had two blanks. I made two of them and they both looked the same. So absolutely not worth it. But I called the company and I didn't call them. I emailed them with the picture and I said, look, has there been a problem with these? And so they asked me like what time, what temperature, what pressure, what, like they asked me all the things. And I told them, you know, I used the Hogg tumbler press and in the picture you can clearly see there was two cups that were made at the same time. One worked, one didn't. So it's gotta be the coating. No problem. Sent me a label. I'm going to send them back. They'll send me, I don't remember if they said they would credit my account or send me two new cups. I don't, but either way, I don't care. Whatever they send me, I'll work with. So if they credit my account, it's no big deal. I'm going to order probably next week. So it's fine. I did order the heat press from them. And the reason I did that is because of right now I have the Cricut, the little Cricut press. I have the medium one, but if I'm doing flags or something bigger for sublimation, this clamshell press will be much better. So I'm super excited to try that. It's that should be coming in soon. I ordered it. I don't know if I ordered it yesterday. I think it was yesterday I ordered it. Honestly, I don't even know what day of the week it is anymore, but I ordered it and it'll be in soon. So I'm super excited to do the review of that. And it's about to get, our mailman's about to come up to the door and my dog's sleeping, so he hasn't heard it yet. So I'm hoping that he doesn't, I'm gonna try to keep him here so he doesn't bark. So just bear with me for a minute. Oh, good, we're gonna make it through. Excellent, he didn't even notice. That's good, he picked up his head, but he didn't do anything, so that's good. I thought, I'm like, if I have to re-record this whole video because the mailman came, I'm gonna lose my mind. So anyway, getting back to that, I'm waiting for my Hogg press to come in. Super excited. I'll do videos on that. I got some supplies from Amazon yesterday, to do the DTF where you print with sublimation on the overhead transfer film. You print on that and then you put the paper on so you can essentially sublimate onto darker clothes. I got some white vinyl coming in from 143 vinyl, the HTV. So what you do is you make the DTF and you put that on the white vinyl. So if you want to print on a black shirt. So I'm just excited to try all these new things and I may make some videos to see what I really need to do and maybe someone can help me out. Like what is the best, easiest to work with video editing software? Like there's got to be a way that I can add in and, you know, my little beginning and add in the, you know, all the things that make the videos cute and special. I want to do that. So I need to find the right video editing software for that. Most of the time I don't film my projects because I swear too much. It's just what I do. I get mad, I get frustrated, and I'm from New England. That's what we do. So anyway, more to come on that. I'm going to show you when I get my heat press in. I got all the supplies coming in. Some of the stuff came from Amazon, some from 143 Vinyl. The press is from Hogg. I'll tell you all that when I do it, but that'll probably be over the weekend, Sunday, Monday, whatever. We'll see. So thank you for watching. I hope you guys all like this. If you enjoyed it, subscribe, share, tell your friends. If you have any questions about the Hogg tumblers or the citrus strip or any of that sort of stuff, let me know in the comments. Let me know if you like these kind of things. And everything, I can't do shopping hauls all the time because as much as I would like to, there's only so much stuff a single person needs. I don't need a lot of stuff. So I am planning, I think it's 2 weeks. I have upcoming this weekend, there's a car show. It's called Milltown. It's a big pre-65. I think last year he might have upped it to pre-67, I don't remember, but pre-65. So any car built before 1965, it's a bunch of bands. It starts on Friday. I think officially it starts at 3 on Friday. The cars will start rolling in at noontime. So it starts at 3 on Friday. I'll be there all day, all day and night Friday, all day and night Saturday, and I'll come home late Saturday night. So I will... I'm excited to do that this weekend, and then I think it's the following weekend that I'm going to build my little wharf pier over here on my porch, and that'll finish my porch, and I give you guys a full tour of the porch. It'll be all done, all my stuff. Everything will be ready, so super excited. Thank you guys for hanging out with me this long. I'm glad that you like to sit here and listen to me drone on about things. I enjoy doing it. I hope you guys enjoy listening to it. So like, share, subscribe. Help me grow my channel. I'm really enjoying this, and I love there's quite a few of you that comment on regularly, and I get to chat with you, and that is kind of nice. I like that. It's kind of like, even though they're you'll never know the people, it is kind of nice to, like, you're getting to know them. So I do enjoy that. So thank you all for listening. Thank you all for joining in. I hope you love the products and the tumblers as much as I do. And thank you all so much. You have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.